interest in certain things. We like certain personalities, we hate certain personalities. We like some books, we hate some books. What constitutes our personality? Whoever is sitting right now here is an integration of a lot of things that person has, had exposure of in his life. We are what we think we are. This totally represents that whatever we have in our mind, registered for ourselves, we eventually become that. If we think that we are weak, then we become weak. If we think that we are strong, then we become strong. If we think that we can become great leaders, then we are eventually going to become great leaders. We are the total club sum of our thoughts. What really constitutes a personality? It actually is a thought. The thoughts which get into our mind, when we continuously start focusing on that thought. There are two types of thoughts, by the way. One are random thoughts, which just come into our mind and we do not pay heed to those thoughts. And there are some another type of thoughts to which we pay really heed, to which we retain in our mind. The thoughts which we retain in our mind eventually become our perception. If there was a random thought, we start continuously thinking about that thought in our head, that thought is eventually going to become our perception. Perception is anyone's opinion about anything, any human being, any personality, any movie, any event. Perception may not be having any facts behind it, but it is because of the repeated thinking of the same thought which you get to have in our mind, that thought converts into perception. And we continuously, when we retain that perception in our mind, that perception converts into our belief. It started with a thought. We retained that thought that converted into a perception. And when we retained that perception in our mind, that perception eventually became our belief. And once we start believing on our belief, which we have developed in our head, that belief eventually becomes our personality. Here, we are trying to find out what exactly is the core factor which constitutes our personality. So with this analysis, we can easily understand that it actually is the thought which has greater influence on our personality. Now it is on us that what exposure do we give to ourselves. If we give exposure to us towards negative content, then the thoughts which we are going to have in our mind are always going to be negative. There is a reason why people say that do not watch bad movies, negative movies, because all those bad movies have impact on our personality. We will not understand that, but though that impact we get to have once we have repeated exposure of a certain sort of content. Likewise, if we want to transform our personality, we need to shift our focus from the negative content towards the positive content. Media, television media is called monger, opinion monger. Opinion monger is a word which is used that when any person is having an influence on anybody's thought, then that person eventually is called opinion monger. Television media controls the brain of so many people. Out of 100% people who watch television, 90% people believe on whatever they are being displayed on the television set. Only 10% people actually involve the thinking process. So if we eventually want to turn into a negative person, we always can have our less exposure towards negative content. We need to have our focus given to the positive books, to the positive thoughts. If we do not have good friends, there are people out there in the society who are only there to tell you that you cannot do it. Your colleagues are going to be there when they'll find competence in you, but they will do what they will do to compete with you, since they do not have potential in them, they will demean you. They will cut your height. They cannot compete you in the right manner. They'll compete you in an inappropriate manner. So you really need to be vigilant. I need to be vigilant. You need to be vigilant. Because there are people who who are called our friends. There are people who are called our relatives. They are with us. We trust them. We believe them. But somehow, the thoughts which they convert into us, the thought which we take from them, is either breaking us or making us. So if we really want to have a personality, if we really want to have a determination which is unshakable, if we really want to have goals which are very high, if somebody is not laughing on your goal, then that means that the goal which you have settled for yourself is very small. Because when people start laughing on your goals, then that means that people are trying to make fun of you, but in their heart, they're having this fear that you might going to do that. So always pay importance to the people you are actually surrounded with, the books you give your exposure to, because all the personalities you meet with, all the books you are going to read, all the television content you are going to see, is eventually going to become the reason of the thoughts which are going to become in your head, which are going to nurture in your head. So if you really want to become a good personality, you need to control your thoughts. Once you will control your thoughts, your perceptions are going to be controlled by yourself. Once your perceptions are going to be controlled by yourself, your belief is going to be controlled by yourself. So by simply controlling your thought, you actually can become a great person of this planet.